please observe a moment of silence for our fallen President Ronald Reagan and for our friends at Noble High School who had a tragedy this week. Faculty, parents, family members, members of the board of directors, administrators, and friends, I would like to thank you all for coming this evening. Welcome to the commencement exercises of the Marshwood High School class of 2004. It is my extreme pleasure to be speaking to you on this stage. After a year of getting to know all of you wonderful seniors, it is both sad and joyous to see you graduate. Joyous in that this moment is the culmination of all you have achieved, all that you have striven for, and all that you have become over your years in school. Sad in that this faculty will no longer have the opportunity to see you in our classrooms, in our hallways, and on our athletic fields and courts. You are a diverse and talented group of seniors and have made me proud to be the principal of Marshwood High School. Parents and community members, you should know that these young people have upheld the high moral and academic standards that I know this community holds dearly. I also know that these graduates will continue to excel in their post-high school pursuits. I remember the day that I graduated from high school. For you seniors, that was back in the Stone Ages. And I remember giving a speech on that day. I was nervous, but I remember feeling, as many of you may feel, that surrounded by my friends and my family, celebrating everything that I had achieved, that my life just couldn't get any better than it was at that moment. Well, I was wrong about that. Being here with you today seeing all that you have accomplished and celebrating your success is a moment that I will cherish forever. Now, I'm a lover of statistics, so let me give you a few about this class. At 212 students, they are the largest graduating class from Marshwood High School ever. They have attended Marshwood High School for 157,000 student days, which amounts to 913,000 class periods. They have done approximately 400,000 homework assignments, 50,000 tests, and many more projects, presentations, and reports. They are an artistically inclined group, as any of you who attended our senior assembly or convocation will know. This class also contains 2 National Merit Scholarship winners, 6 top students from their career vocational technical program, the first full athletic scholarship winner ever from Marshwood, a world-class figure skater, 3 Eagle Scouts, a student who has already begun attending Central Maine Community College on a full scholarship, a Clyde Russell Scholarship winner, and 6 graduates who are enlisting in the military. They have achieved at the highest level, and their promise is unbounded. Now, graduation speeches always contain advice for the graduates. Advice is kind of like salt. A sprinkle can make your food taste really good, but if you pour it on, it kind of gets in your wounds and it stings. So I'll offer just a sprinkle. Graduates, consider your future as you would your past. By that I mean that you should decide what to do in the future by considering what has worked for you in the past. We do not so much create our future as we recreate our past. If you of us should pay very close attention to our past as we plan our future, or if we fail to consider what our successes and failures have been, we are doomed to repeat our mistakes. On the other hand, if we learn from our mistakes and follow the cues of our triumph, then we will triumph again. And I can't seem to triumph with these flowers. But success is not about being lucky. Rather, it is all about realizing the difference between what works for you and what doesn't, and pursuing one while eschewing the other. As you go out into the world of adulthood, choose carefully, for it is these choices that will make you what you become in the future. As I look out over these graduates, I see the faces of many happy people. As Ashley Montague said, the moments of happiness we enjoy take us by surprise. It is not that we seize them, but that they seize us. May you all be seized by that happiness when either good fortune or hard work sends it your way. Realize that happiness comes in many forms. We feel it when we anticipate every new adventure, when we accomplish something we thought was impossible, and when we are surrounded by the comfort of our loved ones. I see all these forms of happiness in all of you today, as we gather to rejoice in this new beginning for you all, to celebrate your accomplishments, and to bask in the warmth of friends and family. May you continue to find all these forms of happiness, whether in your personal accomplishments, your relationships with others, or in the promise that each new day brings. As you enter the world of adulthood, may you find fulfillment, talent, love, honor, and peace in everything that you do. Thank you all, and congratulations to the class of 2000.
Our lives were very different. We were relatively isolated in our home, apart from other children, and caught up in the habit of our daily lives. It was a bit how one might imagine Kansas to be. And when one thinks of Kansas, one thinks of a small girl named Dorothy in a blue and white dress who gets caught up in a tornado and whirled through the air to the world of Oz. There, she puts on a pair of ruby slippers and travels down a yellow brick road accompanied by her friends, a scarecrow, a tin man, and a lion. She finds a wizard who will send her back home to Kansas. How does this relate to graduation, you might ask? Well, 14 years ago, when we were living in our individual Kansases, we were like Dorothy, young and full of latent talents and energy that can only be awakened through a journey in a new and different land. And for us, that new and different land, that Oz, was the Marshwood school system. Like a trickster out of the Midwestern sky, that big yellow school bus ripped us from our familiar surroundings on the first day of city school and whirled us away toward the unknown. At first, we were afraid when the bus ride ended much too soon and slammed us down in front of our elementary school. Like Dorothy, we were far away from our families, alone in a strange place filled with little people. However, as we stepped into our first classroom, we began to realize that the new place was filled with colors, with kindness, and with thought. Although we were nervous, everyone was so happy to see us and so eager to help us. This is the beginning of our adventures in Oz. In Munchkinland, better known as the pre-K classes of Elgin, South Berwick, our teachers armed us with the necessary instrument for our journey through Oz. They gave us perfectly crafted pairs of ruby slippers. While Dorothy's ruby slippers were sparkly and fit nicely on the feet, our ruby slippers were a combination of the age-old concept of the alphabet and the number system, and they fit us just as well. These slippers would be the elements that would carry us through our entire 14-year scholastic voyage along the yellow brick road of the Marshwood school system. Our teachers taught us early on that with the help of our ruby slippers, we would make it down the road to the legendary Emerald City of Marshwood High School. So, with ruby slippers guiding our way, we set off on our journey. We were afraid to leave the comfort of the land of the little people, and not sure what to expect out on the open road. But we understood that we had to keep going. Luckily, we would not have to travel alone for long. Our road moved us through cornfields and forests, and there we met each other. We were all looking for something we felt we were lacking. We had the same destination, the great fortress of the Emerald City, and we decided to travel together. The relationships that developed among us as we traveled together are what gave meaning to our time at Marshall. Our friends shared in our laughter and dried our tears. When one of us was feeling rusty and stuck, our friends were the oil that kept us moving. Our friends protected us against the flying monkeys of our fears. When we wanted to stop and leave the path to rest in a field full of beautiful poppies, our friends were the ones who woke us up and brought us back to the road. Our friends taught us how to trust, how to give of ourselves, and how to be accepting of others. They were there as our path wound through the sunny countryside and through dark, menacing forests. Together, we followed the yellow brick road away from Munchkinland and off in search of what we wanted most. Like the scarecrow, we craved knowledge and searched for it in the books and teachers we found along the way. Like the empty-chested tin man, we were looking for hearts and were confused by the heartache that resulted from some friendship. We were searching, like the cowardly lion, for courage, the strength to face our problems and fears and come out victorious. And like Dorothy, we were looking for a place to belong. We believed that the mystic Emerald City in the distance held the wizard who could fill our empty places and give us what we were lacking. As we traveled in search of this wizard, our travels were not always pleasant. Dorothy was frightened and plagued by a wicked witch in pursuit of those ruby slippers. While our wicked witch did not ride a broomstick or live in a gloomy castle, she existed all the same. legs of our fears and our nightmares, and a stomach of secret hidden problems with which we alone wrestle. Her arms and head were the cruelties of the world that tormented us and those we loved. She wore a black hat of loneliness and insecurity, and a cape of endless, overwhelming tests, papers, and presentations. Though these problems seemed overwhelming at times, we learned to handle them. Sometimes, when our lives seemed to be falling off the pieces, it turned out that all we really had to do was change how we were viewing the situation, and our wits would seem less frightened. Dorothy's wits, though the epitome of evil power, turned into only a steaming pile of wet clothes when doused with water. While we could not handle all our problems as Dorothy handled hers, a giant English paper does not suddenly get an extended due date when splashed with water. Sometimes the answer was unexpected. We learned how to deal with our problems and how to move on. Like Dorothy, we faced black and scary times, but like Dorothy, we had people who cared enough to help us through these times. Whenever Dorothy's journey became too hard and she could not continue, Glinda the Good Witch would come to her rescue. Glinda was her support, the person Dorothy could turn to when she felt alone and lost. We had our supporting good witches as well. People who picked us up when we tripped and fell, and who believed in us when we could no longer believe in ourselves. Maybe for you, it was a parent, a grandparent, a teacher, or a coach. But we all had someone to turn to when we felt like nothing was going right. It was with the support of these people that we continued on the yellow brick road for so long. Because with their love, we knew we could make it down the path to the Emerald City to get what we came for. When we finally reached the Emerald City, we had walked on the yellow brick road for 10 years. Our feet were tired and our heads were spinning, but we had finally reached our destination. When Dorothy stepped through the great green gates of the Emerald City, she was filled with awe and also slightly intimidated, much as we were the first time we set foot in the Amethyst Fortress of Marshwood High School. Here we would finally complete our journey and find what we are looking for. However, when we went to the wizard to give us the gift of wisdom, heart, courage, and a home where to belong, we realized that these were not tangible gifts that could be given by anyone, no matter how wonderful he was. Dorothy and her friends learned that what they were looking for could only be found inside of them. All along, they had possessed brains, heart, wisdom, and the power to return home. They just had to acknowledge these gifts for what they were. We, too, learned that the most important elements in our lives, wisdom, passion, courage, and family, could not just be taught in a classroom. They also had to be learned through experience, and they came from within ourselves. So now, at the very end of our journey to the Land of Oz, we stand here full of experiences the journey has given to us. We are filled with the wisdom of our years, the passion of our hearts, the courage to look forward to our futures of excitement, and the ability to find a sense of belonging wherever we are headed. We are finally ready to leave the Yellow Brick Road for good, to set off past the Emerald City. On our feet, we will wear the ruby slippers given to us in Munchkin Land and strengthened by the journey on the Yellow Brick Road. These slippers hold within them the love of our home and our family, which will always be with us. Because as Dorothy stated, there is no place like home. However, they also hold the promise of our future. As Dorothy learned at the end of the story, she had the power to control what her magic slippers took her. Your ruby slippers are just as magical as Dorothy's, and now they can take you anywhere and everywhere that you want to go. Wear them with pride as you venture out on your own path. The knowledge, the heart, and the courage that you have gained here will carry you forward as you embark on your own individual journey.
the arts and culture within the high school by donating towards artwork in the lobby and a piano for the music program. I'd also like to take this time to deviate slightly from this program by announcing one more gift. To Ms. Charette, I present the framed first edition Senior Skip Day poster.
Of our school district and to present the director's book awards on their behalf. The school board is made up of six elected individuals who spend an enormous amount of time and energy ensuring that our children receive the best education that our community can provide. Please allow me to introduce and recognize these outstanding individuals tonight. If you could just hold your applause, but I will ask them each to stand as I introduce them. Our board vice chair, Mrs. Ellen Reed, Dr. Bill Gilbert, Mrs. Sue Fuller, Mrs. Martha Lee, and Mr. David Allen. Tonight is a celebration of community, the educational community of MSAC 35. Webster defines community as a group of people living together and having interests and work in common. Allow me to recognize who makes up our educational community. The residents of Elliott and South Berwick, parents, family, friends, here today, are our community Marshwood teachers and our dedicated administrators. But it is you, graduates of the class of 2004, who truly make us a community. Because you are the interest and the work that we have all had in common. Whether it was helping with homework, watching you on the field, or just being an important part of your life, we join together as a true community tonight to congratulate you and wish you much success and happiness. And now I simply cannot allow this opportunity to pass without speaking of the leader of our educational community. This is Cheryl Jensen. Our superintendent of schools was called away unexpectedly with a family emergency a few hours ago. But she has decided to fulfill her and her husband's lifelong dream of a boating trip in the coming year. Cheryl's combination of keen intellect, exemplary human instinct, and unfaltering integrity has been exemplified in every decision from the minor to the far-reaching that she has made as Marshwood's educational leader. Her visionary leadership, raising the bar for every one of us, reminding us of the seriousness of purpose of our work, and always asking herself and each one of us the question, what is the right thing to do for our students, established and maintained the focus of our school district on excellence. Whether it was meeting regularly with an excelled student to help them to achieve success, listening to the concern of a distraught parent, or making the dream of an expanded arts program or higher level courses come true. For 4 years, she has truly listened with respect and openness to diverse opinions while maintaining a delicate balance of strong leadership and personal understanding. Cheryl has led by example, and her outstanding personal and professional attributes has set a high standard for others to emulate. She has been a visible, enthusiastic, and respected member of our community. Her words and actions have repeatedly shown that her greatest priority has been the students of MSAC 35. And we have been honored and we have been graced by her leadership. So rather than say goodbye, hopefully she'll see this on a video tape, but but I would like to now invite our community members, our faculty, our school board, and most importantly, our graduates, in expressing our appreciation for her and in wishing her a bon voyage. And now the directors for board. Each year, the chair of the board of directors is asked to present a book to a student chosen by the faculty in each of the academic disciplines to a student from the graduating class who has demonstrated a particular passion and dedication for that academic area. Although the recipient may hold the highest academic average in that discipline, the director for the award recognizes the true purpose of education, a love of learning. And so I will begin with the Science Award. The name of the book that we'll be given is A Short History of Nearly Everything by Bill Bryson, and it goes to Caitlin Moten. In the area of social studies, Voices of Valor by Douglas Brinkley goes to Evan Crowder. Of Metalworking Term by Richard Papanich, goes to Corey Adams. Family and Consumer Science, Including Nutrition, 1,000 Mexican Recipes by Marshwood goes to Andrea Leslie. In the area of Family and Consumer Science and Child Development, The Tale of Depression by Kate DiCamillo and The Man Who Walked Between the Towers by Morgise Gerstein to Laura Bree. In the area of world language, The Linguist and the Emperor by Daniel Meyerson goes to Rebecca Lee. Art. The History of Art by H.W. and Anthony Jansen goes to Julia Walker Lewis. Technology, Laboratory of Justice by Davis Bateman goes to Brittany Goodwin and Andy Shea. Woodworking, transfer project from the authors of Popular Mechanics goes to Keith Barrett. Finally, in mathematics, countdown, six kids vie for glory at the world's toughest math competition by Steve Olson, goes to Rebecca Daly. Congratulations and much happiness to the class of 2004. They are listed in the program. So we have all those students who have received an academic scholarship or an award, a financial award. Please stand up. Apprenticeship or employment.
that we aspire to. Throughout the year, our daily dreams have helped carry us during our time at Marshwood. However, these less significant hopes have also been accompanied by greater aspirations that go beyond our time spent as students. Since our early years at Elliott Elementary or Central School, there have been larger dreams of what we hope to become upon graduation from high school or from college. These dreams of becoming a teacher, or an army officer, or a doctor, or a hairdresser, or a chef, are the dreams that we are now about to set out to fulfill. T.E. Warren, also known as Lawrence of Arabia, once said, "All people dream, but not equally. Those who dream by night in the dusty recesses of their minds, wake in the morning to find that it was vanity. But the dreamers of the day are dangerous people, for they dream with their eyes open and make them come true. And so, I urge you, the Marshwood High School class of 2004, to be dangerous, to dream with your eyes open, and to accomplish all that you have aspired to over the years. I also urge you not to forget those who have supported you through your hopes and dreams, both large and small, whether they be your family, your friends, your teachers, or as in my case, all three, for they too have helped to take you airborne. Class of 2004, the past 13 years have been amazing, so thank you. I know you'll all do great things. Congratulations, guys. We made it.
Thank you.
performance tonight, filling in for Mrs. Jensen, is our assistant superintendent, Mrs. Gail Sullivan. Rebecca Elizabeth Lee. Sarah Elizabeth Gray. Rebecca Jane Bailey. Sarah Ann Ouellette. Jessica Leanne Staley. Mallory Alana Levitt. Laura Joy Frigg. Tammy Marie Percy. Desiree Nicole Lambert. Ashley Marie Butterfield. Katie Lynn Perra. William Charles Royer. Carrie Ann Pack. Holly April Cate. Allison Elizabeth Gordon. Amy Laura Kingston. Sarah Kathleen Crocker. Sarah Elizabeth Geese. Emily Ann Marshall. Kathleen Mary Cousins. Ryan Vieira. Brian Thomas Shaw. Kara Lynn Popolewski. Catherine Paige Chick. Omar Amin Barua. Patrick John Kilborn. Ryan Gray Tevis. Nicholas William Reddy. Jesse May Ammon Carswell. Catherine Lee Krause. David Stephen Whitney. Lucas Storm Mills. Alexander James Frickett. Sally Melissa Dulac. Johanna Catherine Mitchum Wildenauer. Rachel Ann Conley. Henri Cecilia Einstein. Michael Stephen St. Hilaire III. Amanda Jane Crosby. Lauren Ashley Cofrera. Erica Ray Niles. Christine LeBrant. Holly Virginia Jackson Grover. Nicole Ann Hennig. Elizabeth Ashley Baker. Christina Alicia Simpson. Aaron Brickett Staple. Holly Jean Conrad. Dana Rose Gray. Capri Ann Fiandaca. Renee Brooks. Timothy Lieber. Emily Bliss Norman. Yvonne Lenise Castro. Anthony Michael Van Etten. Derek Stephen Cogswell. Natasha Lynn Hoffman. Rebecca Ray Pucko. Kyla Kelly. Anna Marie Upgar. Mitchell Pruitt. Travis Joseph Lazar. Mark Joseph Millicent. Alexander Thomas Hoyt. Megan Anderson. Gina Maria Julia. Yeah. Kelsey Carolyn Reza. Elizabeth Louise Adams. Matthew Robert Sullivan. Justin Hayward Meter. Julia Ann Camagno. Caitlin Iris Moses Wadler. Benjamin Dixon Barr. Robert Gordon Reed. Deanne Rain LeClaire. Scott Christopher Sawyer. Warren Phillips. Alan Michael Burroughs. Stephen Allen Boston. Timothy David Landry. Andrew Michael Shea. Brittany Danielle Goodwin. Keith Gordon Barrett. Corey Scott Adams. Chad Lancaster. Kyle Bruno De Clemente. Andrew Francis Thiebaud. Alex Brian Nichols. Alicia Nicole Coon. Penny Jean Galloway. Benjamin James Lynch. Michael Burrell. James Raboy. Adam Dion. Catherine Elise Morell. Andrew Richard Spagnolia. Daniel Dempsey. John Demeter Kopolis. Bridget Elizabeth Martin. Shelly Stevens. Christopher Clausen. Michael T. Miller. Chelsea R. Craig. Meredith Christine Hay. David Gary Eastman. Luke Folger. James Fry. Megan Christine Galvin. Tanya Jean Block. John Michael Harvey. Gregory Oliver Shingler. Matthew C. Knapp. Miranda Megan Dahl. Gillian Lee Gale. Ashley Dawn Stevens. Catherine Joanne Jackson. Ashley Elizabeth Mondine. Matthew Carl Prep. Jonathan Charles. Oh, Jonathan Charles Brooks. Thomas Jack Keener. Michael Andrew Gaza. Mark Colton Pollock. Alexander Frost Marshall. Gregory Robert Hathaway. Justin Rocky Davis Flores. Jared Waters. Ian Michael Parody. Shane Bob Holden. Andrew Jeffrey Elwell. Nicole Marie McKenzie. Jamie Elizabeth Jenkins. Megan Kate Kavanaugh. Patricia Joy out over Tannis. Shannon Amanda Hodgkin. David Paul Hussey. James Francis Stone. Amanda Catherine Cardwell. Nicholas Allen Benjamin Martell. Duran Robinson. Micah Robert Arthur. John William Pendleton. Jonathan Thomas Lilly. Matthew Anthony Horahan. Brian Joseph DeCredico. Tyler Daniel Goodwin. Matthew Aaron Linder.
Yeah.
Catherine Elizabeth Hart. Bradford Ivan Jones. Mont Jacob Hartman. Johanna Freed. Maxwell William Weiss. Mariah Lynn Archibald Milliner. Chrissy Morrell. Caitlin Howard. Emily Dion. Nicole Lynn Remick. Nicole Christy Stagner. Sean Michael Tolby. Carrie Michelle Kavanaugh. Ryan Michael Short. John Timothy McGowan. Jessica Lynn Roberts. Evan M. Crowder. Anne-Marie Nicole Flayen. Stephanie Ann Braddock. Ryan Carpenter Lee.
and it is composed of 212 different personalities that have blended together over the years. As a group, we have developed so many positive characteristics. We're outgoing, spirited, and bright. We like to have fun, but we step up to the plate with facing obstacles. By supporting each other, we have encouraged each of our best qualities to flourish. The confidence that we've built in each other is reflected in our ability to work well together to test the limits. And our class has been known to test the limits. Although some may consider this a negative attribute, in many instances it has worked to our advantage. In the classroom, we frequently question the material we were taught, allowing us to express our personal opinions and ideas. Seniors were strongly represented in athletics this year as well, and their effort and abilities resulted in competitive teams. Many members of the class showed through their service that the young people can have an incredibly positive effect on a community. The class also challenged authority, learning the importance of compromise as we attempted to further the interests of students. In challenging the structure of life at Marshwood, seniors asked many questions. In the spirit of our inquisitive nature, we have compiled a list of the top 10 most frequently asked questions by the class of 2004. And the list goes as follows. Number 10, when was that application deadline? Number 9, why is it that we aren't allowed to leave the cafeteria once we've entered at lunch? Number 8, how much money did we pay for that sculpture hanging in the lobby? Number 7, which is better, Elliot or South Berwick? Number 6, Johnson, Livingston, or Sanzone? Number 5, why is it that there is a soda machine in the teacher's room and not in the cafeteria? Number 4, is it conceivable that there's a book Mr. Cousins hasn't read? Number 3, is it really illegal for the administration to give up parking tickets in the Marshwood lot? Or necessary? Number 2, do you think that I could have an extension on that paper? And the number 1 most frequently asked question by Marshwood seniors is, are senior sick days sanctioned by the administration? As important as these questions once seemed, this year we also had to ask ourselves about the future. When these silly questions are just memories of high school. What school will I attend? What job will I take? What will life be like after Marshwood High School? Well, for a group of such diverse individuals, it is sure to be an interesting experience. We will continue to test, challenge, and question what we know all too well, and also the unknown we're about to enter. Hopefully, all of us, members of the class of 2004, will keep our sense of wonder and vivacity for life, because it is inevitable that these characteristics will continue to work to our advantage as we discover what life is really like after Marshwood High School. Congratulations, class of 2004. We did it!
Thank you.
graduate Lamont. Then they will form a circle in the middle of the field and throw the hats up into the air. The police are not